So now we see what is called the dice operations. Dice operation is nothing but within a slice I have one more. First we see the query, select location key, comma some vehicle sold from sales fact where location key is equal to 1 and product key is 1, group by location key. So what I will do exactly within a location, I already know in the slice operation what is that, the location 1 is 270. In the location how much product 1? 20. Product 2 52. Product 3 84. Product 4 is 116. Like that. So what I will do is the slice operation defines subcube by performing the selection of 2 or more dimensions. How many dimensions actually in the cuboid? The cuboid dimension is location. This is product. This is time. So there is 3 dimension. How many dimension I am using in the query? In the query I am using what? 1 dimension, 2 dimension, location dimension and product dimension I am using. How I got this 20? This 20 is nothing but location 1 and product 1. You see here, location 1 and product 1. How many rows are coming? Only 4 rows. Location 1, product 1. This is location and product. No. So only these 4 rows. So 6 plus 2, 6. 6 plus 6, 12. 12 plus 8, 20. That's why we got answer is what? 20 here. So 20 is a dice operation. So dice operation is what? In other words, specifying value ranges on one or more dimensions, the user can highlight meaningful block of aggregated data. Dice operation is a slice. Within a slice, what I'm doing? I'm making another slice here. That's what I'm doing. So more than 2 consecutive slices. What exactly dice is doing? This gives summary. 272 is a summary information. Within summary, little bit more detail. The data values what? Summary, more summary, detail, more detail, like that. So this type of operation helpful for aggregation of the aggregation level or hierarchy of information we are getting based on the analysis. That is a useful thing. This type of OLAP.